questions and get answers over various school board meetings. Along the way, other options were also presented and also considered, by the way, so that was not the only option considered by the committee. And so that there was an option for an early childhood or a pre-K center that was presented. There were options on just redrawing the boundary lines and keeping everything sort of as is, but just sort of redraw the boundary lines. Another option, we call it option D, was presented last month as taking some of the preschool students that currently are sort of peppered throughout some of the schools, not all the schools, and relocating some of the preschool classrooms to other schools. Most notably, Marie Schaefer has a significant portion of preschool students. But one of the issues with that is Marie Schaefer is a pretty full school. There's not a lot of room to add growth to Marie Schaefer. And the issue again is we've got expected growth from a city, you know, building and home construction perspective. And those students potentially would go to Marie Schaefer, so where do they go if the school's already full? So
to a early childhood education center. And I could talk forever. I think Mr. Keller, most of the staff knows how much I care about Evans and having two kids that came through Evans, and I could talk a long time about the staff, the parents, the involvement, the work that the students put in there, and a lot of the things about the people that are around that building. But I think we've heard a lot of that conversation, and we all probably know it. One thing that we haven't talked a lot about is the uniqueness of that facility, and I wanted to really focus on that for just a moment. What I'd ask you to think about is, as you look at those considerations you have tonight, look at the gem that we have as a collaborative educational environment, truly unique in most of the Metro East, certainly unique in O'Fallon, and allow us to continue to educate students that prepares them for success in major corporations around the country, rather than turn that into an alternative education. I think it's a great place for those little kids, the preschoolers, who might have a place to learn and prepare, but for our K through fifth graders to learn that collaborative environment, I think that's priceless, and it'd be a tragedy to lose it.
We mentioned back in December that we would take a vote in February, which gave everyone a chance then in January to address the board to consider things, to have us consider options and discussion from the public. And so here we are tonight for the vote.